हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर रूपाली बोरकर, ईएनटी कंसल्टेंट प्रैक्टिसिंग एट अपोलो क्लिनिक्स। टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस विथ यू रिगार्डिंग हियरिंग लॉस इन जिडियाट्रिक पॉपुलेशन। इट इज़ द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट हैंडीकैप अफेक्टिंग द एल्डरली पॉपुलेशन। इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज एज रिलेटेड हियरिंग लॉस और प्रेस्बैक्योसिस। इट इज़ अ बायोलैटरल सेंसरी न्यूरल टाइप ऑफ हियरिंग लॉस विच अफेक्ट्स बोथ द ईयर्स। इन दिस टाइप ऑफ हियरिंग लॉस देर इज डिसफंक्शन इन ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ साउंड फ्रॉम द इनर ईयर टू द ब्रेन। Gender wise, it more commonly affects the elderly males. Causes of presbyacusis are genetic predisposition, noise exposure, microvascular changes with age, and altered metabolism. Presbyacusis, it usually affects higher tones and consonants, which results in poor speech comprehension and communication. Patients find it difficult to localize sound in background noise. Patients, they also complain about ringing sensation in ear, which is characterized as buzzing of insects inside the ear or whistling of train. For management, we advise a pure tone audiometry test, which helps us to quantify the hearing loss. Then, according to the audiogram, we advise hearing aids or amplification devices. Apart from the behind the ear hearing aids, which are easily seen from outside, there are also in the canal hearing aids or implantable hearing aids which can hardly be seen from outside, and we advise them for cosmetic purpose. It is generally assumed in our society that hearing loss is a part of aging which can't be controlled and that it seldom affects our day-to-day life. But no, it does affect in the form of loneliness, depression and cognitive decline in our elderly population. So timely intervention with hearing aids is quite beneficial. So if you have this complaint of hearing loss or ringing sensation in the ears, get yourself diagnosed and treated and don't neglect. Thank you.